नमस्ते, हरिओम, वेलकम टू शेवधी चैनल। वी विश यू ऑल अ वेरी हैप्पी, हेल्थी एंड ब्लेस्ड 2021। एंड एज वी एम्बार्क ऑन न्यू ईयर, यू नो मोस्ट ऑफ अस वुड हैव ऑलरेडी मेड न्यू ईयर रेजोल्यूशंस। एंड एज वी नो द हार्ड पार्ट इज you know, is in keeping those resolutions and working towards achieving our goals. And I just thought of sharing some of the self-transformation tools that actually I learned from one of my teachers, you know, my respected guru, Dr. Usha Katyayini. Actually, she is one of our teachers at Yes Vyasa Yoga University. While I was doing my MSc Yoga Therapy at this esteemed university, Dr. Usha Katyayani taught us this subject, Yoga Philosophy and Health. And she is a wonderful teacher and an accomplished doctor as well. And while teaching that subject, she also set us off on a self-transformation journey by providing us with a list of pointers, you know, what we can do to work on ourselves and make a better version of ourselves. So I thought, you know, why don't I talk about these pointers if these are going to help you as well. I will just read out those tips first, and then we will go into each and every pointer one by one. The wonderful you know, set of suggestions that she gave us was: be mindful and get involved in volunteering activities, which is the very essence of karma yoga, and practice yoga. Think green and go green. Engage in spiritual activity. Learn to let go, and develop an attitude of gratitude. Smile and make things fun. And she also talked about how to do fasting the right way. So I just added a few more things based on what we heard during those lecture sessions. Cook right, eat right, and fast right. Okay, so this it turned out to be a very you know, effective transformation tools for us, and I benefited from it. So I thought of sharing these with you all. The first tool was to be mindful. So what do we mean by mindful? It is basically being aware of or being conscious of things around us, or each and every moment of our life. So when we are aware and very conscious of each and every moment of our life, that actually opens up a new dimension altogether. Conscious of the things happening, we will pay attention to that thing, and we won't react the wrong way. So we will try to engage our intellect and try to get rid of any unproductive or negative thought that might actually come into our mind. So being mindful actually is a very effective tool which will stop us from you know, dwelling on negative things or worrying about the future, but concentrate on what's happening in the current moment. Next one is volunteering activities. This is the, you know, very essence of karma yoga, doing something to help others without expecting anything in return. The volunteering, you know, what are the benefits of volunteering? In fact, getting involved in these type of tasks is good for both the body and the mind. It actually helps boosting one's self-confidence and self-esteem. And when you do something good for the community and good for others, it actually gives us great sense of accomplishment. You feel that you made a difference in somebody's life. And believe it or not, considered to be one of the very effective tools for combating mental health conditions like depression. The key risk factor when it comes to depression is the feeling of loneliness. Talked about mental health in one of the videos. I'll provide a link to that. This is one of the things or the one of the conditions that many people faced, especially in the year 2020, given that horrible pandemic situation that gripped the entire world. So when you get involved in this volunteering activities, you will be in regular contact with other people, and when you get involved, you will understand, you know, life isn't easy for everybody, and you're not the only one going through whatever emotions that or the challenges that you are facing. And that gives you a support group that will help you come out of that medical condition. So that will help. So volunteering in fact will be like a great therapy. When the mind is healthy and mind is not stressed out, obviously it will have a positive effect on the body as well. Volunteering doesn't have to be, you know, you don't have to go and find an organization to work with. You can do small things for your own friend circle or your family, or you know, do something for your neighborhood that might make a difference. You know, it doesn't have to be a very big thing that needs to be published in a paper or anything else. It is something to help anybody in your circle. The next very effective tool is yoga. Practicing yoga is a wonderful tool. It is just a great life transforming tool that I have personally experienced. Typically, when we hear yoga, we think that is just yoga asanas. Asana is just one limb of the yoga shastra as a whole, the science of yoga. There are many, many aspects. If you have heard of Patanjali's Ashtanga Yoga, eight-limbed yoga, it is basically for transforming all aspects of our very existence. You know, it is for the body, mind, intellect, and beyond that. Okay, so I have talked about it in a separate video about Pancha Kosha model. So in that, you know, I have discussed, you know, how yoga helps all five sheets of our existence. Just coming to yoga. We say that, you know, we don't have time to do this. Typically, that is what I hear. You know, I have done it myself a few years back. When we get so consumed in our career and other aspects of our personal life, we tend to neglect our own health, both physical and emotional health. And then we will face the consequences and dealing with those you know, ill effects. It is very, very challenging. It can be challenging. So obviously prevention is better than cure. So take up you know, any form of exercise. And yoga, I personally benefited from yoga, and also I recommend yoga because it actually helps not only for the physical body but also for the well-being of your mind and intellect as well. So if you, even if you don't have time, all you have to spend every day is just 15 to 30 minutes of your time. There are so many videos out there. You know, just learn Surya Namaskara. That itself gives you a number of asanas in that, and then do at least 3 to 6 rounds of Surya Namaskara, followed by Nadi Shuddhi or Anulom Vilom Pranayama. That is more than enough. You know, you, I think you can spare at least 15 to 30 minutes of your time to keep your health in a very optimal level. So if you have a healthy mind and body, you can enjoy whatever you are earning, right, or whatever you are achieving. So at least for that, you have to maintain good health. So that is the next tool. So take up some form of physical activity and also something to help relax you and your mind. So that is where yoga plays a very effective role. Next one is think green and go green. So basically, you know, this is the mantra, right? Reduce, reuse and recycle. It is not only to do with not using some of the things like plastics and always carry bag that is made of environment friendly material like jute or cotton. Use such bags when you go shopping. And when you have some festival or some other function at your place, or when you're gifting somebody, think of gifting them a plant. Also, think twice before you buy anything. It is like, do you really need it? Sometimes what happens is, given the current culture of these sale events, notifications popping up, and even though we don't need it, it's like kind of a want kind of thing, so we just end up buying it. Even if you I'm not saying absolutely don't buy anything, but even if you buy it, think of giving something away which is still in good condition to others who are in need of such things. So that way you are recycling, you're not just wasting things. And if you can try to recycle kitchen waste, you can do it at home. You don't need a big place. You can have a container. You keep collecting all these after you cut the peels and everything, you collect those, and once they go through that composting process, you can use this for your plants. So that way you're making a difference to the environment as well, and you feel good about it. And when you have some little plants on your windowsill, easy to grow and maintain, the plants are available, for example money plant, and then the ZZ plant, all these things are very hardy plants and good for the air also. They purify air, and you can get those and you can grow them even in indoor, and also even if you have a small balcony, you can keep those there, and you can keep the mini plants on your windowsill, and you can take good care of them. And when you look at those plants, it gives you a sense of happiness, and tending to those plants is another very relaxing activity that you can get involved in. And next one is engaging in some spiritual activity. How does this help? By spiritual activity means it could be chanting some hymns, or doing we have this practice of daily worship routine that our parents have taught us. You could do that, and also sometimes you can listen to this spiritual or philosophical discourse or devotional songs videos on YouTube. How do these help us? These actually have an effect on our mental sheath. So when we listen to these things, it actually clarifies our thought process, and we will be able to do the activities and make the right decisions in our life. So this is how getting involved in this spiritual activity will help you. The next one is learning to let go, or learning to forgive. See, this is easier said than done, that I agree with you, but carrying the baggage of those old emotions and some old fights doesn't really help us. it just spoils our mind, and it will in turn have an effect on our you know, physical body as well, and then it will, it could spoil the relationships as well. So I was listening to one of the lectures on YouTube, and it was beautifully said that when you meet a person, think that you're meeting that person for the very first time. So if you dissect this you know, suggestion a bit, what that person is saying is, when you think that you're meeting the person for the first time, that means you're not remembering or you know, recollecting any of the past experiences with that person. So when you have that, you will have those preconceived notion in your mind, and that will carry, that will have an, you know, impact on the current interaction that you're going to have with that person. So if we can apply that, you know, we won't really harbor any negativity or any type of animosity with anybody, and have a normal, no baggage interaction with everybody that we meet with. So we just have to keep practicing this. When you forgive, it's not that you're forgetting that experience, but you're not carrying the baggage of that particular incident that is going to spoil your own peace of mind. And developing and maintaining an attitude of gratitude, that is another thing that we can practice. Basically, we tend to complain about the things that we don't have, but we don't really observe what we already have, what the, you know, we are blessed with. Smile and make things fun. You all have heard this adage, right? Laughter is the best medicine. That is indeed very true. And as per the medical research, smile actually activates the brain's left frontal cortex. It's the area that makes one happy, and it helps in releasing endorphins as well. So it is, in fact, the humor, it's a very effective tool in diffusing any tense situation. It could be at work or in any, you know, situation in your family circle. Use humor at the expense of others. You can use self-deprecating humor, but when you make jokes, make sure that it's not hurting anybody else, even if it is a difficult situation. Let's just smile and say, okay, fine, it's there, we'll handle it. Okay, if we try to develop that attitude, it will definitely help us and help everybody around us. Cook right, eat right, and fast right. What do I mean by cooking right is, what is food? Basically, it's the form of energy that we consume in order to keep our body and mind going, right? So when we are cooking food, if we are like in a bad mood, in an angry mood, or if we are arguing with somebody, you know, having a verbal fight with somebody, then what is happening is all that negative energy is getting absorbed by the food that we are cooking. And when we consume that food which is cooked in that environment, it is not going to have a positive effect of on our body or on our mind. So please calm yourself down when you're about to cook, and you can play you know, soothing music in the background, or you can listen to some you know, podcast, or you can have a fun conversation with your people, or you can listen to some devotional songs in the background, and then do cooking. And eat right is basically same thing. If you're angry or if you're arguing, please don't eat. Wait until you calm down, and then you have your lunch or dinner or anything that you're going to eat. So that is why our elders used to say, when you are eating, you're not going to talk with anybody. So I think that is the very reason why they had made that rule. And you know, over time, nobody listened to that particular thing, because we didn't understand why it was being told. So when we don't understand why we do something, we tend to forget and just stop doing practicing those things. So now we really know why we were told not to talk while having food. Keep this in mind. Don't do any working lunch or don't eat food when you are discussing something. Just have a calm mind first and then you start eating. And the fasting, right? What do we mean by this? Is I'm not talking about any fad diets or any other type of fasting. It is actually a way of cleansing our system. Our elders had this system of fasting twice a month on the Ekadashi day and also on some particular festivals like Sankashtahara Chaturthi, and they wouldn't eat something on some special occasions. So these are all the methods that they had come up with in order to cleanse the naturally cleanse the organs. So this will give a break to our digestive organs also, and it will help them in recovering and getting energy back, and they will function better. And so another thing that you can add to this is when you fast, you can set aside an amount of money, a fixed amount of money. You can think that, you know, if I had eaten that day, right, it might have costed me 100 rupees, just an example. And just set that money aside, and after you accumulate a certain amount of money, you can give that money to a charity, which will definitely be a fabulous idea. You can incorporate this, and you're not only helping yourself but also helping others through this way of fasting. So these are some of the tools that we were taught, and I extremely benefited from these things, and hope you can also adopt these things in your daily routine, and to whatever extent you can, if you agree with these things. And wish you all a very happy, healthy, and blessed 2021 again. Hari Om. Thank you.